Welcome to Pack Expo Connect Live, and indeed welcome to Hapa. Today we're going to be talking about late stage customization. We're also going to be taking a close look at our BlisterJet technology. We won't make a factory tour in this event, but if you'd like to see the factory tour, please check out our Web 4.0 video. We're downstairs in the production area now, in front of this BlisterJet, the Hapa 807, which is a late stage customization unit, which will allow a company to implement a postponement strategy. In order to understand what a postponement strategy is and why it's interesting for pharmaceutical companies, we first need to have a look at how the production profile in a pharmaceutical factory has changed over the last 25 years. So 25 years ago, when I started in this industry, a typical production profile from one of my clients would have looked something like this. In other words, a lot of big batches, batch sizes down here, number of batches on this axis. Most companies had large volume production, which meant low complexity on the lines. And those blister packaging lines were allowed to do what they're designed to do, to produce blisters day in, day out, with very little disruption from the volatility that we see today. Over those years, over the 25 years, the production changed, and today it looks something like this. There's still a great deal of large volume production, but the majority of it is smaller volumes with higher levels of production complexity. This production complexity leads to poor utilization of the blister packaging lines, because the lines spend more time standing still and being changed over than they do actually running. There's an area of interest which has grown over recent years, which is an area that resides here in the curve. This area here, which would be represented by batch sizes of less than 3,000 blister packs, this is the area that's interesting for a postponement strategy or for late stage customization. And that's because when you try to run a batch of 3,000 down a blister packaging line that runs at 600 blisters per minute, the utilization drops to a very low level. Another area which is addressed by late stage customization is forecast accuracy. If on this axis I have forecast accuracy, and on this axis I have batch size, well, if you're producing very large batches, aspirin for example, then you've got a pretty good idea how much aspirin we're going to produce for different markets in Q4 of 2020. If on the other hand you're making an oncology product, which is thankfully in very small volumes, then it's quite difficult to predict how many of those products are going to be required in Q4 in Peru. And therefore, forecast accuracy is very difficult for these small volume production. This is where a postponement strategy really starts to help, because you only produce blank blisters on the blister packaging line. This allows the blister line to do what it's designed to do. You get the OEE level really up for this type of production. And then you're able to react very, very quickly to the market demand. As soon as the order comes in for that small batch for Peru, you can release the blisters from inventory and print on demand and deliver to the market within days. To explain more about the machine, I'd like to hand over to my colleague Misho now, who'll go through the features of the machine.
So in this space, there will be the feeding unit of the blister jet. Depending on the speed, there are different feeders available. They can run up to 300 blisters per minute. There is also a decurling unit available, which is decurling the banded blister. And here is the entrance of the blisters into the blister jet. The blister is transported with a pre-sized belt system. It grips the blister at the edge to make sure that it's flat during the printing process. Here we see the heart of the blister jet, which is at the moment in the park position. Once you press the start button, it will move over the belt. In this case, we are having a CMYK printing module with a resolution of 720 dpi. Next to the printing unit is the pinning unit, which makes sure that the print on the blister is kept sharp. Here we see the LED drying unit which makes sure that the ink on the blister is dried properly. Next to the drying unit is the camera system, which makes 100% full inspection on the blister. So next, the blisters are passing the reject station and going to the downstream machine. So what we have here, at one end, the blank blisters are entering the blister jet. And at the other end, late stage customized blister.
Misho, thanks for the demonstration. Before we go and take a look around the production area, which I'd like to do with you, just quickly summarize the benefits then of a postponement strategy or of late stage customization. Why is it interesting? Well, first of all, as mentioned earlier, utilization of the blister packaging lines. When you decouple that complex production from the line and you allow the line to produce blank blisters, then you really improve the OEE on the line and you let the money-making machine run more of the time. Another benefit is speed to market. Everybody wants to be faster today. And with a postponement strategy, you can react instantly to different market volatility, thanks to a higher level of agility in production. Reduction of material inventory means, in this case, aluminium foils for different markets, or indeed finished goods inventory is also a huge benefit of postponement. And waste. There's significant amounts of waste in pharma production. Most pharma companies will admit to wasting around 12% of their aluminium foil annually. It can certainly be higher, but with a technology like this, you can reduce that waste really down to the bone. Finally, all of these benefits add up to a financial benefit, which is a fast return on investment. Since we've got some time, what I'd like to do now is take you around the production area and let's have a look at some of the other machines that we have here. So the first machine we're taking a look at here is the Hapa 216, one of my old favorites. We've sold well over 1,000 of these machines around the world during its life. And this is a flexographic printing machine, meaning that it uses a flexo print mat or an analog print mat for applying the print to the foil. A lot of our customers really appreciate the simplicity and robustness of this technology. And as you can see, it's installed onto this module here, which is purely for testing purposes to make sure that when the machine leaves the factory, it's completely soak tested. This machine is a Hapa hybrid, one of our big sellers. It combines the advantages of flexographic technology with the flexibility of digital technology. In most cases, the flexo unit is used to print the fixed artwork while the digital module is used to apply the variable data. But indeed, the digital unit can actually print the entire artwork as well. So this machine gives the best of both worlds. This machine is a Web 4.0. It's close to the end of production now to be delivered to a customer in here in Europe. As you can see, we have four color bars. This is a CMYK machine. This particular machine has a first in it. It's the first time actually that we've integrated the camera into the machine frame, as you see here. So we have unprinted foil coming in, being printed in full color and being inspected by the integrated camera inspection system. So we're in the south wing of our production area now, another Web 4.0. This one is actually destined for the United States. And just opposite here, we have another blister jet in production. This is the smaller version of the machine we saw earlier. And this would be the machine used for 1 and 2 color applications. Last but not least is this Bfs Jet, a machine designed for printing on blow-fill seal packs like this one, on either the body or the flag of the Bfs. Particularly important in this application is the ink and the ink chemistry. That's because we need to check for any migration properties and we need to have a robust and secure application. You can learn much more about our ink and our ink laboratory in one of the other live stream videos. Before we go into the Q&A session though, I'd just like to spare a few words about our North American team. We're based in Allentown in New Jersey. Our US facility is fully stocked with spare parts for all of the machines that we have installed in the United States. We have a fully trained service crew who are available for on-site service and troubleshooting. for installations, for training, and of course, important during COVID times, is remote service. Also based out of Allentown, we have our sales crew headed up by Steve DeAngelis. And indeed, those individuals are experts in pharmaceutical technology, in pharmaceutical processes, and of course, in supply chain. So they're well placed to advise you on the best ways to implement technologies in order to get a quick return on investment. So we're now going to switch to the live Q&A session. There's no questions that I can see up on the screen yet. So what we're going to do is we're going to switch to some common questions. You can see below that we have our sales consultants available for you. So Misho, if you'd like to join me here by the machine, maybe if I place the first question. How long does it take to change from one blister format to another blister format? If you want to do a changeover from one blister dimension to another blister dimension, what's involved and how long does it take?
So actually, as you already mentioned, size is depending on the blister size. What you actually need is only one tool, and this will be that one, to adjust the transport belt. So depending on the blister size, you need that tool to adjust the transport system, and it's taking you less than a minute to adjust the format.
That's perfect, Misho, thank you. Obviously, if we do a changeover of the blister dimension, that's just one element of it. What about artwork? So what's involved in changing over an artwork? Let's say we have the same blister, but we want to now create an artwork for another market. What's involved in a changeover there?
So you go into the HMI where you can choose the prepared artwork. So it's taking you even also less than a minute to change the artwork for the blister. So you'll be ready very, very quick for the production with the new artwork.
Perfect. So of course, everybody says that they've got fast changeover on machine, but here with this one, we can really honestly say changeover within a few minutes. Another common question related to the vision system here is how you teach the camera in order to make an inspection to make sure that every single pack is identical. And what I can tell you is here that we're actually not going through a teaching process because we see that as inherently insecure. So we don't show the first blister and then go. We don't do a so-called show and go. Here, the PDF is indeed the master, the PDF, which is the original released artwork from your network. And it's that file which is used as the reference for the camera system. So we are really referencing the correct data. Another question for you now, Misho, then, a little bit about speed. So what's the maximum throughput for a machine like this?
So depending on the blister size, of course, the speed is a little bit, there is a little bit of difference. But the max speed on the BlisterJet is actually 300 blisters per minute, which is an average speed of approximately 35 meters per minute.
Okay. So thanks for that, Misho. What I would say about speed is that most of the customers using this type of the technology are looking at managing very small batches, so normally the machines would run slower. So we're almost at the end of our live stream here today. I'd like to thank everybody for joining. If you do have questions, you can contact us directly. There should be a link, certainly in the email or in the live stream feed that you see below. Thank you very much for joining, and I wish you a very good evening or day. Thank you.